I do research in the area of cardiovascular diseases and in the area of obesity and diabetes. I believe I settled on cardiovascular because of my own personal relationship with that disease in my family. My father had his first heart attack at 51, and he went through 3 open heart bypass surgeries, lived until he was 80 because he was so dedicated to watching his diet. But no matter what he did, the lipid problems just kept coming back. And I think that just kind of made me like, I wanted to know, well, why aren't we able to help someone like him? Did I love science as a kid? No. I actually wanted to be an English major. My parents were Depression-era parents. They hadn't been given the opportunity to go to college. So they told me that I had to go into healthcare because they wanted me to be able to always make a living. I chose pharmacy, and then when I was in pharmacy school, one of my professors approached me about doing research. I didn't even know what it was. So the first experiment I did was he had these mollusks, you know, and I had to add a little drug into where the mollusks were sitting there. And then I, under a microscope, counted how many times their little cilia beat. It was the most boring thing I have ever done in my life. It's amazing that I stayed in research, but something about it, something intrigued me. I love trying to come up with a question and design an approach to tackle the question. You don't go into it for the money. You go into it because you want to help people. I made this finding many, many years ago, before the epidemic of obesity that we experience in the United States, that cells that are in our body that are called fat cells make part of the renin-angiotensin system. That system controls your blood pressure. And so if these fat cells are overproducing parts of this system, that could be why obesity is highly linked to problems like high blood pressure. So one of the areas of research that I do is really looking at how can we control that fat cell and make it stop producing these parts of the system so we can effectively minimize high blood pressure. I'm going to tell you about another part of my laboratory. This part is you ready for a little wild ride now? I'm going to tell you a bit of a wild ride. So this work has been done over the last 15 to 20 years in collaboration with Alan Dougherty, who's the head of the Cardiovascular Research Center. Basically, we found that if we expose mice to angiotensin II, which is the main part of the renin-angiotensin system, they develop abdominal aortic aneurysms. This is a very dangerous vascular disease in humans. You and I, as females, were less likely to get an aneurysm compared to men. And so I'm trying to understand, why is that? What I've been studying more recently are our chromosomes, specifically our sex chromosomes. I've been looking at the contribution of those sex chromosomes to this vascular disease of aneurysms. And I think I've made a really exciting finding over the last year. I can make a little female mouse get an aneurysm basically by giving her the male chromosome. Why do I think this work is important beyond aneurysms? Well, we've become more aware in this country of gender and gender identity. And from my perspective as a cardiovascular researcher, what is important to me is part of the process of seeking one's gender is to take certain types of sex hormones to promote the outcome that you would like for that gender. My concern, or my hopefully contribution, is how will that therapy influence that person's cardiovascular health? And so I hope that my research has a broader impact in helping just provide knowledge to people as they seek their own gender identity and what the different types of approaches and clinical care they would need to do that. So for me, you know, I mean, what is the point of me doing any of that research if it doesn't have an effect or have an outcome that's beneficial to the community? I mean, why do we do what we do? If it doesn't make a difference, there's really no point of it, is there? And that difference can be from my perspective of trying to improve cardiovascular health, or from the perspective of writing a poem that, you know, makes somebody's soul move forward or elevate their soul. So it's really all types of work and research and activity that we can do that can make people's lives better.